Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I am going to show you how to install macOS in VirtualBox on your Windows PC. So if you have ever wanted to try macOS without needing a Mac, this is your chance. Let's dive right in. Before we start, make sure you have VirtualBox installed on your PC. If you haven't done that yet, go ahead and download it from the VirtualBox website and install it. Once you have VirtualBox ready, we will need to download a macOS image. You will need a macOS installer file or an ISO image. You can find these through legitimate sources if you have access to a Mac or through other means that you trust. Now let's open VirtualBox. Click on New to create a new virtual machine. You will need to name your virtual machine, so go ahead and name it macOS or anything you prefer. For the type, select macOS X. For version, select the one that matches your macOS version. If you're unsure, go with the latest one. After that, we need to allocate memory for the virtual machine. I recommend giving it at least 4 gigabytes of RAM, but if your system has more, feel free to allocate more to improve performance. Next, we need to create a virtual hard drive. Select Create a Virtual Hard Disk Now. You can choose VDI for the hard disk file type. I recommend at least 40 gigabytes, but you can choose more depending on your needs to finish setting up the virtual machine. With the virtual machine created, let's adjust a few settings. Select your virtual machine. Click on the Settings button. Next, go to the Processor tab and give the virtual machine at least 2 processors if possible. This will make the system run more smoothly. Now let's attach the macOS ISO image. Under the Storage tab, click on the empty disk icon under Controller IDE. On the right side, click on the disk icon and select Choose a Disk File. Find your macOS image and select it. Now let's tweak some more settings for macOS to run properly. Under the Display tab, increase the video memory to the maximum allowed. This helps macOS run better and look better too. Once all the settings are done, click OK to close the settings menu. Now click on Start to boot up the virtual machine. At this point, VirtualBox will start the machine. You should see the macOS installation screen pop up. Go ahead and follow the on-screen instructions to begin the installation process. It will ask you to select the language first. Pick your preferred language and click Continue. Now the next step is Disk Utility. Select Disk Utility and click Continue. Here you will need to format the virtual disk you created earlier so macOS can install on it. Select the disk on the left, then click Erase. Make sure you choose APFS as the format, then click Erase again. Once that's done, close Disk Utility and go back to the installation screen. You should now be able to select the virtual disk you just formatted. Choose it and click Install. The installation process will now begin. This might take a while depending on your system's performance and the macOS version you're installing. Be patient while it installs. It will reboot once or twice during the process. Once the installation is complete, macOS will start up. The first thing you will see is the macOS Setup Assistant. Follow the on-screen instructions to set up your system. This is where you will set your location, language, keyboard layout, and more. After that, you will be asked to sign in with your Apple ID. If you don't have one, you can create one or skip this step for now. Once you're through the setup process, you will land on the macOS desktop. Congratulations, you have successfully installed macOS on your Windows PC using VirtualBox. Now that macOS is up and running, let's take a quick look around. If you're used to Windows, you will notice a few differences. For starters, the macOS desktop is clean with a lot of space for your files and folders. At the bottom, instead of the taskbar you're used to on Windows, macOS has something called the dock. This is where your most used apps live. You can open apps like Safari, Finder, or the App Store by clicking on their icons here. Now up at the top, you will see the menu bar. This is different from Windows, where everything is in the taskbar. On macOS, the menu bar changes depending on which app you're using. It's where you can access settings, Wi-Fi, and volume controls. Let's take a look at Finder. This is similar to Windows File Explorer, where you can browse your files and folders. It's easy to find what you need and everything is neatly organized. Now, if you press Command and Space, that's your version of the Windows Start menu. It's called Spotlight, and it helps you quickly search for apps, documents, or make a quick web search. Let's open Safari. This is the default web browser on macOS, just like Edge or Chrome on Windows. It's fast and simple. It comes with nice features like reader mode, which helps you read articles without distractions. Moving on, let's look at the App Store. This is where you can download new apps similar to the Microsoft Store on Windows. You can also update your apps here to make sure everything is current. One thing that might be new to you is the Messages app. This is like texting, but built into your computer. If you use an iPhone, this app will sync with your phone, so you can send and receive messages directly from your Mac. Another useful app is Photos. If you've used a phone before, you know how photos are organized in one place. If you use an iPhone, they automatically sync with your Mac. Now let's check System Preferences. This is where you can change settings, similar to the control panel on Windows. Here you can adjust things like your display, trackpad settings, and more. On macOS, multitasking works a bit differently. If you swipe up with three fingers, you can see all your open apps at once in something called Mission Control. This makes it easy to switch between apps and stay organized. One last thing to mention is Time Machine. This is macOS's automatic backup system. It works in the background to keep all your files safe, so you never have to worry about losing them. Now let's wrap this up. You need VirtualBox and a macOS ISO file to try macOS in a virtual machine. That's a quick rundown of macOS and how it compares to Windows. If you're coming from Windows, there is a learning curve, but once you get used to it, macOS is very user-friendly. Thanks for sticking with me through the tutorial. Now you know how to install macOS on your Windows PC and get started. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more tech tutorials. If you have any questions or run into any issues, drop a comment below. I will be happy to help. If you want me to make another video on how to install another operating system in VirtualBox, just say so. I will make a full tutorial like this one with details to help you out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.